Hello, I am Marinus de Pouter and I help management teams to remain future-proof. I regularly receive questions about risk ownership. I hear stories about line managers and project managers who have been appointed as risk owners. In addition, usually their organizations have risk managers. Or how about having even separate control owners? Or on top of that, action holders. That's how colleagues responsible for control measures sometimes are referred to. You will recognize this from your own practice. It does not clarify the matter at all. In addition to the regular accountability structure for managing a process, project, department, location, or division, somehow a separate structure is created for dealing with risks. That isn't terribly handy, and fortunately it can be organized in a more future-proof way. As a management team, always keep things as simple and straightforward as possible. Avoid unnecessary complexity like the plague. As an organization, you have to create and protect value for your core stakeholders. Therefore, think very practically, starting from the value change for your customers. Define your success using your goals and specified objectives. Make all colleagues involved responsible for jointly achieving those goals. Those accountable for objectives must also be able to determine the business processes and projects to achieve these objectives. The activities are the basis for managing expectations. The process of project managers, or owners if you prefer to use that term, need to be vigilant for opportunities and threats if they are to live up to the expectations. They must ensure that they take benefit from opportunities and limit threats. In order to do so, they also need effective working standards and working methods. Some call these control measures. Those responsible for achieving objectives must design, execute, evaluate, and improve their processes and projects, including the controls. They need specialists for that, for example, in the field of technology, compliance, IT, housing, finance, safety, and privacy, simply as part of the regular pan-do-check-act cycle. Do not use all sorts of separate terms starting with risk, such as risk owner. Avoid unnecessary complexity, as this is what makes your internal and external clients happy. I trust your team will benefit from these tips, and more will come.